question I have received is about a divorce talaq that someone went to the local imam and they pronounced a talaq, and they went to another group that somebody says not a talaq. So sure we have to do, and even it's affected or it's not affected. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This is a very sensitive matter of our society, because many of the scholars aren't aware of something, and rather I including myself, I've seen so many like hundreds of videos on YouTube on the matters of a talaq, and I'm sure many of you have seen the many videos on that, that the people is asking, public is asking a question to the imam or the mufti or the sheikh or anyone, and he's basically just basically answering that it is affected, or the three talaq is one talaq, or the three talaq into the one sitting. But let's understand something. Even if it's a one or it's a three, like first let's clear something. According to the Quran, when it says the talaq maratan, that means the talaq is two times. That the Quran does not mean if you say talaq two times and if you say third time that the relationship will be over. Now this is the one issue. According to the Quran, let me clear why it says talaq maratan. Talaq maratan means like simply the Quran, the talaq is two times. Like for example, you give the talaq one time and you have to give again, and after some time, after the period of time, either you accept it or you reject it, or after the period of time you can give a talaq again, and for that's the last one. And the third time if you do it again, the relationship becomes over. So this is the what you mean, the talaq is two times. The Quran does not say if you say a talaq two times in one sitting, the Quran even doesn't even say you say talaq two times. The Quran says talaq maratan, talaq is two times. If you say one time, then after a period of time you cool down and you accept it back, that is affected. Now here is another issue. Majority of the scholars are failed to realize something. Even it's a one or even it's a three, it's scholars, it's obligation to scholars, and it's an obligated to the scholars to go into the deep and then answer the question if it is affected or it's not affected. But most generally the answer is yes, it is affected. But if you go more into deep into that, when we found the information in the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ, if you want to give the talaq, it has to be when the time of the menstruation of a woman is being passed and the period is being over, you have to give her talaq into the purity without touching her. Now this is the way to give the talaq. Now what if you just have an intercourse with her and you have sex with her, is that affected? Now that is something like a talaq bid'ah. Talaq bid'ah is not affected. Now some of the scholars would say okay, this is accepted. If this is it's accepted, now let's go back to the hadith where the Prophet said waqullu bid'atin dalalah waqullu dalalatin finnas, simply anything something like not the teaching of the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, that is being rejected, that is bid'ah. So similarly, when somebody says pronounce talaq after the period in pass and somebody has a sexual intercourse and give a talaq, that is talaq bid'ah. But is it affected? No. Into the mid, some of the scholars they will say if it's affected, some of the scholars, so the scholars who are related to the other sects of the Islam, like groups or anyone, they will say okay, this is affected, talaq bid'ah is accepted. Now is now let them ask them a question. The Prophet ﷺ said waqullu bid'atin dalalah waqullu dalalatin finnar, all the bid'ahs will lead to the hellfire. So that means the bid'ah is totally unaccepted. And also Prophet ﷺ said any amal or any action that is against the sunnah is being rejected. So point to be noted, any action that is against the sunnah is being rejected. Now many would scholars would say okay, so it's okay, it's been accepted. So even they even those scholars accept it, but this is something it's not from the sunnah. So let's understand something. Even they will say this is affected, but again this is not something from the Quran, this is not from the sunnah, so that is something like against the sunnah. So when you say this is not from the something sunnah, that means you can you're free to do whatever you want. Either you can accept her, you can reject her, or you can accept it. Even you don't even have to divorce, and if you want to go against sunnah, that means you're free to do whatever you want to do. When the hadith, the Prophet, if you do not have the haya from Allah, then you're free to do whatever you want to do. So why you bring the, why you making this too much complication, if this is affected or not affected? When somebody says, when the Prophet all the bidats been lead to the hellfire. So every action that is being against the sunnah is automatically rejected. So how is that bidat, talaq bidat is being accepted? So this is the scholar's own opinion. According to the sunnah, this is not something from the sunnah, this is their own opinion. So the sunnah way to do that is when the menstruation and the periods of a woman is being passed, the husband has to give the divorce without touching her, and if he touches her, then he has to wait for another 2 cycles to do that. Now what about those people? So this is the something majority of the scholars has been failed to do, that not getting into the deep into understanding more how it was being happened and was it affected, even it's a 1 or even it's a 3 or whatever. But the scholars has to really go out asking more questions. But the general answer for that one is this is not affected, because this is not affected. And if somebody give the 3 talaqs or 1 talaq or anything after the periods, and there, some of the scholars will say they accept that, some of the scholars will reject it. If you ask my opinion, I would not accept that, because the Quran say, because Sunnah Prophet give the talaq after the periods without touching her. So that's very clear answer, that when somebody touches, so that means that's the form of the talaq bidah. So talaq bidah is not accepted. So then he has to wait for another 2 cycles to wait for that. Because one of the also hadith says that when I believe it's Abdullah bin Masood, I believe, I'm not sure. So he asked the Prophet about the, he pronounced the talaq for his wife. So then the Prophet into the hadith, then he said, take her back and you have to wait for next cycle, then you have to wait for another 1 cycle. So also another thing, something, if somebody gives a talaq, like for example, if a woman gets purified after the periods, now the husband and wife had an intercourse after some time from between one period and other period, and they have the sexual intercourse between that time, and after a few days after, or the weeks after, or 2 weeks after, they got into the fight, the husband pronounced talaq. Is that effective? Now this is something very important. Is that effective? No, still that is not effective, because that was supposed to be done without touching. But if you do that, that is again a talaq bidah. The proper way to the sunnah way to do that, the husband has to wait until the 2 cycles to give the talaq, until she is purified. Because majority of the cases I am being receiving, I believe more than 95% of the men, they get angry and shouting on husband and wife conflicts, and they finally end up with giving a divorce. Next morning they call them and they say, okay, now what should you do? Now let's understand, by naturally, if a man gets angry, he's get temper, he has a short temper, he's gonna shoot the bullets. Does that affect? That's gonna blow up like millions of families like that. So this is a very sensitive matter that every scholar has to see, that how the divorce is being affected, or even it's a 1 or it's a 3, but still they have to go more deeply in getting in a counseling with the client, and I have to ask them more question, how was it affected, and what did they have the sexual intercourse, was it after the periods or before the periods, or how it happened. So they have to go to all through this question, then they are supposed to be issuing the fatwa. But not just like my husband gave me 3 talaqs, is it affected, and the scholar is going to answer, okay, no, it's not effective, it's only 1 talaq. But rather, the scholar has to go into asking the question, is it affected after the intercourse or before intercourse? And he has to get all into the list of questions. Then he has to finalize after the list of the questions, then he has to finalize and come to the conclusion that was affected or not affected. Not just say yes or no, or it's affected 1 or it's affected 3, but rather go through the all list of the questions, then make a final judgment, okay, that was affected or not affected based on the Quran and the Sahih Hadith.